Hey guys, so today I have a review of Dark Matter, and I gave this book 4 out of 5 stars, so I really enjoyed it. I'm gonna do like a spoiler-free part of this video, and then I'm gonna be doing a discussion video, but I will do full warning when I'm about to go into the spoilers. So to give like a really brief synopsis of this book, it is a sci-fi book. I went into it pretty much blind, and I enjoyed it so much because of that, so I'm not really gonna give too much away with my brief synopsis of this book, but basically there is a middle-aged man named Jason, and he is a college professor, but he's actually a really incredibly brilliant physicist. He's working at a local college, but 15 years prior he was working on a scientific breakthrough that really could have changed the entire world. He had a girlfriend, I guess, at the time, and she got pregnant with his son, and so he decided to have a family life to take care of his son instead of pursuing his scientific career. So at the start of this book, Jason is abducted, and when he comes to, he's in the same city, but his wife isn't his wife, he doesn't have a son anymore, and his life is completely different. And so it's Jason's job now to kind of figure out what he's going to do and where he is and how it happened. There's honestly not much further I can say that wouldn't spoil anything in this book, so I'm going to be going into the discussion and the spoiler-filled part of this video. But I really just have to say that it was an amazing read. It took me only 2 days to finish, and it was just purely entertainment. I don't read much science fiction, and this one just kind of blew me away. It made me want to read more science fiction, so for that, I think it was a really good book. So if you're watching now, I hope that you're okay with spoilers, because I'm gonna go into some finer details with this book that I especially loved. I want to start off with the character of Jason, because I think he was such a good character, and what was so great about him was how dedicated he was to his cause. Like, I love that even though he saw this whole new Jason he could have been in this whole wonderful life, he would have been rich and famous and incredible, he doesn't even for a second consider stepping into that life and just forgetting about his old life and his wife and his child. He is like 100% dedicated, loyal to Daniela and Charlie, and he is not gonna let anything stop him from getting back to them. So I love his dedication and his loyalty. I love that we didn't really have to question that he was gonna fall back and he was just gonna kind of give up. Like, there was such a drive in him, and I just thought he was a really good main character because he just really moved the story along. And this book was just really great for posing some fascinating theories that I don't really think about. Like, I didn't even take physics, so just like having this multiverse theory and kind of exploring that was just incredible to think about. But they made the concepts really easy to navigate and really easy to understand for someone who isn't so scientifically minded in that kind of way, and so for that I really enjoyed how the author took these theories and made them practical and like available for us to figure out, because it was like quantum physics we were talking about, but it didn't sound so lofty and so far out of our reach to understand. I have to mention something that I didn't particularly love about this book, because I did give it 4 stars, not 5 stars. Something that was a little frustrating for me was how long into the book it took us to finally figure out kind of what was going on. Maybe you saw it coming, or maybe you knew because of a synopsis you read before, but me going into it blind, I was just completely clueless, and it got to the point where I think I was about halfway and stuff was just starting to unravel, and I was like I feel like some of the unraveling could have happened a lot sooner. I mean, I'm still okay that it happened in the pace that it did, but I also wouldn't have minded if we had figured some things out sooner. And one thing that always really frustrates me in a book is when nobody believes the main character and they think the main character is crazy. Like, that drives me wild. And that was the whole first half of the book. Like, nobody believed Jason. Nobody thought that he was in his sane mind. Okay, I have some questions about Amanda, because I feel like all of our questions didn't get answered. And I know, you know, authors can do that in a creative way to let us figure it out. But okay, with Amanda, she just leaves a note and disappears. And I want to know, like, a novella, just like a little like article from the author, like, what happened to her? Like, what does her life look like? Like, what Chicago did she step into? Or did she even step into a Chicago at all? I want to know how Amanda's life turned out, because I think Amanda was a really important character to the story. Jason was going insane, like completely going insane. So the only reason he stayed as sane as he was because of Amanda. Just, I wanted some closure with her and I wanted to see her again, and we just didn't get anything. So I just would like a little something from the author, just like, oh hey, Amanda's doing fine, she's loving her Chicago life and she has a great happiness, and that's really like all I want for her. Also, I have a lot of questions about this Chicago. So the final Chicago where Jason 2 is, and then like the million other Jasons that pop up because of the multiverse theory, wouldn't there just be like an infinite number of Jasons possibly living living in Chicago. Like, I feel like literally that whole earth would just get populated with all these alternate versions of Jason, and I just don't know how that would play out. Like, what happened to that Chicago world? Like, what did those other Jasons do? Because I just watched Jason and Daniela at the end go off with Charlie, and I'm just like, okay, but like, what are you gonna actually try to live a life here? There were like four or something dead Jasons out by that safe house that they went to, and so what are they gonna think when someone comes across those bodies and sees like four of the same, exactly the same dead people, and then they just keep seeing all these exactly the same looking people around town and around the world? I feel like that world would get thrown into chaos just because of the amount of Jasons that entered the world through the box. There's something that happened to that Chicago, and I want to know what it is. One thing, going back to Jason's character, I'm just really glad that he wasn't the one to kill any of the other Jasons. Like, he killed Jason too, which I think was fair, but I think what set Jason apart, like our Jason, like the one we love and the one we were hanging out with this whole story, was that he was so dedicated to his family, and he was getting a little crazy, but he also wasn't a monster. And these other Jasons we saw, like, were complete monsters. Like, they were killing the other Jasons, and that was not okay. I mean, if one of those guys had ended up with Daniela and Charlie, I would have been scared for them. But no, they actually end up with like a really decent human. So like, I'm just so happy that our guy just stuck it through. He didn't lose his cool completely, and he finally got freaking Jason 2 in the end. I hated him. And then as for the actual ending, I don't know, like, I'm okay with how it ended. Like, I saw that as being a possibility, that he was gonna go into the box and they were just gonna go to this whole new world. But then again, I'm left with all these questions, like, where did they go? What was a Chicago like? Like, how did they get new identities? Or were there another duplicate Charlie, Daniela, and Jason in the Chicago that they stepped into at the final scene, which we actually don't know if it's Chicago. I'm assuming it's Chicago because this whole book is in Chicago, but we just see green and trees and pretty, but like, what if there's another Danielle and Jason out there, and Charlie? And then this other set just walks into their lives and completely disrupts everything. I just have a lot of questions about what actually happens now. I feel like this book was so good for hooking me, and it just left me wanting more, as you can tell by all of my questions at the end of this video. Let me know all your thoughts, theories, and crazy questions below in the comments. Thank you so much for watching, and happy reading.